We are in section 20.7, Laplace transforms. So first, let's write down the definition of Laplace transform. So F as a function S equals to, and sometimes given a notation, a L of a function F, capital F, T. So if you have a function capital F T, you do a Laplace transform, you get the little s as a function of s. So it's defined as, so integrating 0 to infinity, e minus s t, f as a function of t and dt. Okay, so that's the definition. And in many other books, instead of using s, common notation is using P instead of S, but that doesn't matter. Okay, so by this definition, you see that is there's some similarity with the Fourier transform. The main difference is that the integration now is not the whole range of T, it's not from negative infinity to infinity, it starts from a certain point, we call it zero. Of course, this zero you can move to anywhere, just your choice of the initial time. Okay, so yeah, from initial time to infinity, so that's a difference compared with a Fourier transform. Another one is the multiplication with exponential function instead of an imaginary number times t. Now you have a s, which is required to be a real number, at least in the definition of Fourier transform now. And later on, when like doing inverse Fourier transform, we can extend the s to a compact spring and in the sense of analytic continuation. But for now, when we do the transform, we assume s is real, and to require the integral exists. So usually you need to assume that S is a positive real number. Of course, depends on whether F is exponential decay. That can extend S to a positive range, but then if F is not exponential decay faster than exponential minus ST, then you require S to be positive. Okay, so that's the definition. So because of the difference in the definition is start from finite time, we call it zero. So Fourier transform is most useful in solving differential equation with an initial condition explicitly specifying the initial condition. So we'll see that when we talk about some properties of Fourier transform. But before we do that, in this section, mainly is to give some example of Fourier transform. Just let's try some function as capital F and see what we get for the Fourier transform. Okay, so the next one is, there's also mentioned some of this property of whether how Fourier transform would be some condition for existence and that and all that, and also the property that the Laplace transform is linear, but those you can read yourself. But let's go on to the some example. So the first example is really trivial, is if F is just a constant like one. Okay, and it also requires T greater than zero, but that actually doesn't matter because we integrate from zero to infinity. So then F will be just integrating the exponential function, which right? Straightforward, because integration exponential function is an exponential function. All you need to do is divide it by 1 over s and evaluate of 0 to an infinity. So at infinity is 0 because of the power, assuming s is positive. Okay, and so what you get is 1 over s. Okay, so that kind of straightforward. This is 20.129. Okay, so, and the next one is an exponential function. So ft is equals to e to the k t. All right, so this is kind of straightforward like the previous one, because you just combine the exponential function in the definition e to the minus t st with this e to the kt, so you get e to the k minus st. Okay, so dt. So of course in order that this integral exists, you must assume that s is less than k, right? I mean, f is greater than k, s is greater than k, so that the coefficient now in the exponential function exponent is negative. Okay, so you require that. So if that's true, then the integral is just like the example before, so become s minus k. Okay, so you require s greater than k. Okay, and this is 20.130. All right, and once you have the exponential function, there are other function which is straightforward, the cosh and sinh, because if it's cosh of kt, which now just becomes 1/2 of e to the kt plus e to the minus kt. So obviously, using the previous result, you have this fs will be 1/2 of the first term is just the previous one. The second one is just changing k to minus k, so it becomes s plus k. So, and you can get the common denominator, and what you get is 2s. Actually 2s, and then you cancel the 2 in the denominator. So just s divided by s squared minus k squared. So this is 132. And likewise, if it is a sinh kt, just 1/2 of e kt minus e minus kt. So f of s will be the same thing, except now it's minus. This term is minus. So when you combine the two, you actually cancel the s, and you have 2k and cancel with the 2 in the denominator. So you get k divided by s squared minus k squared. So that is 20.133. Okay. And similarly, for sine and cosine, I'm going to do the same thing, because ft is equals to cosine of Is it k again? K, kt, which is by definition is e to the I kt plus e to the minus I kt. So this result is basically the cost with k change to I times k, and all you need to do is to change the s square minus k square to s square plus k square. This is 20.134. And for sine, now it's 1/2 I E I K T minus E minus I K T F S S. Now this is like sin. Again, changing K to negative K, but you divide it by I also, or just multiply by negative I. So you have minus I K S square plus. And actually, since k changed to ik, so ik times minus I becomes 1, so you actually don't need that. K square plus. This is 20.135. Okay, so. All this based on exponential function, integration exponential function, which are the easiest. Now the next one is slightly more complicated. So ft is just t to the power n. And n doesn't have to be integer. Okay, and this implied S is by definition is integrating 0 to infinity to minus S T T to the power N D T. Okay, and that this integration for integer N is easier to do. You can do integration by part repeatedly, and for non-integer n, we actually have seen this before when we talk about gamma function, which is in chapter 13. So let's look up the definition of gamma function first. At least one of the definition. So remember f. So gamma z is defined as 0 to infinity e to the minus t t to the z minus 1 dt. This is equation 13.5. Okay, so by comparing this form with this one, so you need to do a change variable instead of t, you integrate over st. So this t to the n become s t to the n, but then you need to divide it by s to the n, and dt become dst divided by s. So altogether it divided by s to the n plus 1. Okay. And now in order to get the gamma z, this is z minus 1. This if this is n, this becomes n plus 1. So this is equals to gamma to the n plus 1 divided by s to the n plus 1. Okay, so and this is 20.146. Okay, so this by definition of the gamma function, you require n greater than negative 1. Okay, so that is the power of t function. Okay. Now the next one, the next example is f to t is equals to a so-called step function, heavy size step function. So the step function is like here, f t is equals to defined as this ut minus k, which is in the textbook writing is 0 for t less than k, 1 for t greater than k, and the value for t equals k is not, doesn't matter when you do the integration because it's just one point. Okay, so this means that of s is now, of course, assuming the k is greater than 0, that would make it integrating k to infinity e to the minus s t dt. Okay, and now the integration again is straightforward. It's just exponential function. So you get 1 over s e to the minus sk. Okay. And that is 20.138. Okay, so that kind of straightforward. And the next one is just combining the two, this one and the previous one, just a ut, which is just basically one, So this is example 20.7.1, which is kind of straightforward. So we don't actually have to write it down, but for the next one, ft is a delta function. Delta t minus t zero. Again, assume t zero is greater than zero. So this is integrating e minus zero to infinity minus st delta t minus t zero, so equals to e to the minus st zero for t zero greater than zero. And this is 20.139. Okay, so we have done some, at least for some elementary function. Of course, there could be a whole lot more you can do. And we will just stop here. These are just for example. And next time we'll finish the rest of this section.